Today I'd like to talk about the Oilers' goaltending. If you're active at all on social media, then you're probably familiar with the most common opinions about the Oilers' netminding. The most prominent one I've seen is that it doesn't matter if the Oilers improve their goaltending unless they upgrade their defense. And people will point to Devan Dubnyk as a prime example. Look what happened with him once he was playing behind a legitimate NHL defense. Well, let's take a closer look at this. First, let's examine what happened with Dubnyk. I'd say that for his first few years in the league, he was an average goaltender who was prone to a weak goal from time to time. But everything went sideways when Craig McTavish had this inexplicable question and answer session with himself at a meeting with season ticket holders.
Stupid is what stupid does, sir.
This was stupid on a number of levels. One, it gave birth to the first of many McTavish-related memes. Two, if he planned on dealing Dubnyk, he lowered his trade value substantially. And three, he completely shattered Dubnyk's confidence. Confidence is important in every hockey player's game, especially young players and goalies. So, was it any surprise that Dubnyk struggled right from the start of the following season? After he bounced around a bit, he finally winds up in Arizona, and this guy is the reason he transformed into a Vezina candidate. If he could turn this goofball into a Vezina nominee, he could do it with anyone. Dubnyk's demise began with a guy who couldn't keep his feet out of his mouth, and his resurgence began with a guy who taught him where to keep his feet in the goal mouth. So let's get back to the Oilers. After things fell apart with Dubnyk, they brought in Scrivens and Faust. And the goals against just continued to pile up. So, for people claiming that the Oilers' goaltending situation doesn't matter unless they upgrade their defense, look at these goals! It's true that Scrivens and Faust were probably just average goalies on great teams before they came to Edmonton. But as you can see, these goals shouldn't be let in no matter what team you're playing on. Former goalie coach Frederick Chabot certainly shares some of the responsibility for this. But having said all that, the biggest issue in Edmonton the last 2 years was not the quality of the defenders and goaltenders. It was the system being executed on the ice. The Oilers' defense and goaltending was in a cyclical gong show of awfulness under Dallas Eakins' Timbits hockey philosophy of a swarm defense. If you aren't familiar with it, basically how it works is everyone attacks the puck carrier hoping that he panics and gives it away. But this is the NHL, so he's probably skilled enough to find one of his four open teammates in the slot. This strategic nightmare led to the goaltenders trying to do way too much to compensate for their defense, cheating off the post early, trying to intercept passes, or trying to make all the passes. Sure, the Oilers could use better defensemen, but it doesn't matter if your defense is made up of a bunch of all-stars if your team is playing shinny and the other team has a game plan. You may have noticed that I haven't even mentioned Cam Talbot. That's a good acquisition, but it's not really about who the Oilers got. Among goalies who played at least 20 games last year, Scrivens and Faust were second last and dead last in save percentage. Now, I like Scrivens. I really do. I think he's got a great attitude and he's a good team guy, but he couldn't stop a beach ball last year. Any goalie in the league would be an upgrade on what Edmonton had. Whether Talbot is slightly better or significantly better remains to be seen, but he will be better. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.